Excellence, Mr. Donfried, ladies and gentlemen, the title and some remarks of my speech are Berlin, the place to be. The future of a modern city depends on its inner liberality. Welcome to Berlin, and I hope that you have a good time here. If you arrived some days before, then you had hopefully the opportunity to see something from the city and not only the conference venues. That is every time the same, how you can learn about the places where you are be. And very welcome for you all. And a special welcome to the delegation of Catalonia. And today is the Catalonia Day in Berlin. And the representatives are with us, and I'm very proud that I can be a part of this conference. Berlin has about 17 partnerships with cities all over the world. In Spain, it is Madrid. But for me, it was my term in, as governing mayor. I had a lot of encounters and official contacts with Barcelona and the representatives of Barcelona and Catalonia. For example, I had the honor to open the Willy Brandt Place in Barcelona in 1st of February 2009 with my former colleague, Mayor Jordi Heroy, and that was an amazing event. For me, and especially with the name of Willy Brandt, you have heard a little bit about not only the former chancellor, also one of the best mayors what we had here in Berlin. Barcelona and Berlin are competitors for Olympic Games or for other big sports events, but also for fashion. For example, we had a battle with a bread and butter fashion fair or show. They started in Berlin, then they moved to Barcelona. I was very unhappy about this, but some years later, then they came back to Berlin. Now they finished, they are not in Barcelona, not in other places, or not in Berlin. That is life. This year I was in Barcelona, invited by Dr. Peters, chairman of the Circle of German-speaking executives, and that is a very good organization to bring Germany and Spain together, and I think they have about 350 members, mainly from big companies or middle companies in Barcelona and surrounding, and they are very active in the society, and especially Mr. Peter. He has a lot of contacts to famous politicians in Catalonia, for example. And for the Berliners, and for all Germans, especially the Balearic Islands are very popular, not only for vacation, but especially for vacation, and the representatives is here. And we met us by the International Tourism Fair here in Berlin every year. There you have a wonderful presentation for all the opportunities for tourists in Spain and especially Mallorca and the other islands. We all know that the political situation is full of conflicts in your country between the independence movement and the government of Spain. I hope that you will find the right decisions for Catalonia and Spain. I know that it is not so easy. We can declare it here and have the hope, but to organize it, to make a compromise between the two positions, that is very complicated. But it's important not only for Catalonia and for Spain, it's also important for whole Europe, I think. And therefore, we are looking to your country, and we hope that you have the power to make a compromise and to create a better future for all. All the best to you. It's not an easy job, I'm sure. We are now at Christmas time. In Berlin, you can visit many Christmas markets. And at this point, I would like to commemorate the victims of the terrorist attack on the Christmas market from Strasbourg. And we all know that our public life is vulnerable to such attacks. We had to experience that in Berlin in December 2016 at one of our Christmas markets here in Berlin. The fight against terrorism must be the common task for us Democrats in every part of the world. Berlin is today one of the most exciting cities in the world. And 29 years ago, we had all the remembrance of the fall of the wall. And images of dancing people crossing the wall went around the world. The 9th of November 1989 was for me the most exciting moment in my political life. I never believed that it will happen in my lifetime. That was the situation. And from one moment to the other, we had the fall of the wall. It was a peaceful revolution by the citizens of East Germany, not the cleverness of governments. It was where the movement of the citizens. It was possible with the help of politicians that I have to mention, like Mikhail Gorbachev with his policy in the Soviet Union, perestroika, glasnost, and his understanding and also the support to this moment. And we are thankful that was a peaceful revolution and it had been in another way if there are only one soldier from the side, from the former GDR or from Soviet Union, had not the nerves for this process. What will happen then, I don't think about it. So it was a peaceful revolution, and that is, for me in my political life, the best thing what can happen. Today you will only find remnants of the wall. The Brandenburg Gate has become the symbol of the new unity and freedom for all Berliners, and not only for the Berliners, for whole Germany. With the opening of the Brandenburg Gate, a door into the future, a better future in peace was opened for Berlin. That was not only important for us, it was also important for the whole world, because the end of the Cold War between West and East was the result of the opening of the Brandenburg Gate and the fall of the wall, and the end of the Iron Curtain. And that was only in history, it's not so long time, 29 years. And next year we will celebrate the 30 years anniversary of that. But what happened all in the 29 years? We thought at the time, remember to 1989 or 1990, that we don't need armies, the confrontation, power of the East and the power of the West is not necessary. We will create a better world for all. Was the idea and the hope. And the result, we are a little bit afraid about freedom and the situation in the whole world. After reunification here in Berlin, we thought that Berlin would have a huge development. At that time, we had over 3 million inhabitants, and the prognoses were that Berlin will rise to 6 million inhabitants in 10, 15 years. That was the thinking at that time. And the reality was quite different. The federal government stroked the Berlin promotion in 1993. They reduced the Berlin subsidies from one day to the other. It was the right decision to reduce them, but not from one day to the other. They didn't need a process. We had no chance to rebuild the city. The result was we lost about over 300,000 industrial jobs. You have to know that the big companies were located in East Berlin, and they collapsed because they are not able in the new political and economic system to compete with the others. And in West Berlin, we had only companies were subsidized by the federal government. They are also not competitive to the other, to a free market. It was horrible. And to lose such a huge number of employees and working places, that was a horrible situation. And that was in 1993, that was a point of reduction. And the result was that we had a very, very bad economic situation. I can remember the numbers of unemployment rate in Berlin were by 19%. 19%. Today we are 7%. That was a very, very bad situation. And at the end, it was not growth and prosperity were at the Berlin agenda, but a long time of depression. It was not so easy to change it. As I started in 2001, I urged a change of mentality, away from subsidies to self-initiative. The feeling in Berlin was the situation is so bad, what you can do? Then you can make 5 million, billion deficit, or if you make 10 billion, that's the same, because we have not the chance in the next decades to pay it back. So therefore, what you have to reduce the cost and have a lot of trouble with your inhabitants. Since my government, 2001, we invested a lot of money to support the high technology parks like in Adlershof or in Buch. We co-financed the research institutions. We rolled out the red carpet for companies in the creative sector. It was not very popular at that time because the feeling, the meaning by the laborers or by the company organizations were it's only good to invest in an industrial job. But at that time, Invest Europe were the industrial jobs. Yeah? So we had nothing against it, but where were the companies who will build up a new car a fabrication in Berlin or the pharma industry or whatever. So that was a reality, and therefore to change it and to say we have as a big city and with a special fluidum in the city, a good chance with creative industries that was in Germany not so popular. In UK you had a special minister in the government for creative industries, but in Berlin to say creative industries are important, that was not so popular. But it worked. Today Berlin's economy is on a good way. We have a boom by startup companies. In the industrial sector, we have still 105,000 employees. The startup companies has now about 100,000 employees, and every year more. And that was the real success. At the beginning, we had them not on our agenda. They started in Berlin, in Kreuzberg, in Neukölln, in the whole city. And then they don't come to the administration and say, we want to have subsidies. Subsidies, that was not a word for the startups. They had their idea. And they want to make money. That was different to the new economy some years ago. But then they need venture capital. And today we have more venture capital in Berlin than in London, for example. That is not from Berlin, because there's a social structure is not so that you have the rich incomes here in Berlin, but they are coming from United States, from other parts in the world, and invest here in the young startups. The assets, a very good place to live, very diverse and international. No problem to hire well-educated and specialized expert from all over the world. That is an experience. In former times, they said, yeah, we are going to New York or to other places in the world, but now it's easy to come to Berlin, and they want to do it. IT companies has grown, and the challenges of the digital world can shape the young startups. That is a good combination, and therefore, it's not an alternative to have industrial jobs and startups. We need both, and they influence together. That is not a firewall. They have not the same language. They have not the same behavior. You don't find by the contracts, for example, that is limited by the startups, that is unthinkable in the industrial sector, or they have no laborers there, and they have an after-work party, for example, together, and quite different. But they need the other part for their business, I think. And therefore, we build bridges between the two sectors, but that can be very successful. Berlin is poor but sexy. That was one of my famous sentences. Today I can say Berlin is not a rich city. That is not true, but not so poor as it was in 2003, where the sentence was created. But I'm very proud that it is still sexy. And that is not so easy to organize it and to live it, because the costs are going high. If you want today to rent a flat or an apartment or to buy it, now it's so expensive like in Hamburg or Munich, and that is a challenge for us. And for the people, it's not the best situation, but that is that shows us that the economic situation is quite better than in the last years. Berlin is a metropolis in the middle of Europe. Big cities are in a good and mostly fair competition. By all differences, we have the same problems. We have the duty to organize the life in our cities in the best way. That means a good infrastructure is necessary, enough affordable apartments for all, good jobs, the best education, a good public traffic system, sustainability, a community full of respect for minorities, and not only respect, of also to acceptance, and integration for all. Professor Richard Florida, economist, University of Toronto. I don't know if he is still a professor, but some years ago, he gave us a good inspiration for the big cities. In his book, The Rise of the Creative Class, he explained to us that the three T's are decisive for the success: technology, talent, and tolerance. To attract creative people, generate innovation, and stimulate economic growth, a place must have all three. Berlin is an international metropolis where people from all over the world live mostly peacefully with each other. You have to create an atmosphere with acceptance for all. A liberal feeling is necessary. If foreigners are not welcome, then you will lose the competition with other attractive cities. If a dark-skinned person is afraid to go into certain areas, then you have lost. If a gay couple is afraid to go hand by hand through Berlin, then you have lost. If a Jewish man with a kippah is afraid to go to his synagogue, then you have lost. Berlin is a metropolis that is open to the world. People from various European and non-European countries live here, and this has profoundly influenced the city. About 100 different nationalities. We are living in a multicultural society. And it's not such a long time that the conservative party here, the Christian Democratic Union, for example, they said, no, we are not multicultural. What thinking? You have to look around and then you can see it. That is not a question of ideology. That is a question what you can see every day and what you can live. Berlin believes it has an historical obligation to do everything it can to make it possible for Christians, Muslims, and Jews, as well as those of many other faiths, to live together in peace in the city. Diversity is an enrichment and not a danger. Against discrimination and exclusion, an enlightened modern society must defend itself. I know that it's easier to talk about integration than to do the job on site every day. And it's also a question of quantities. We had learned it after 2000 or in 2015, as a lot of refugees came to Berlin with the support of our chancellor. Therefore, the causes of flight in the countries of origin must also be combated. And we need an effective common European refugee policy. Today, Europe and many other countries are in political and social turbulence. The populists and simplifiers prevail against established parties and institutions. We have heard it. We have to learn that everything is questioned. I have the impression that democracy has become on the defensive, and that is dangerous. And we have to learn 60, 70 years after the Second World War, democracy that is for us, our life. But is it in danger? Is it forever? You can have a lot of questions. Globalization, digitization are a threat to many people. The world of work will revolutionize in a short time, and in a shorter time than it was in times of the first industrial revolution, for example, or in other parts in our history. Convincing answers to these fears are sought. They are not yet found. This is a job for us all. Let's do it, and thank you to your academy, ICD, that you are organizing such a process to discuss and to find answers for the question of our present, and that we are able to manage it for a better future. And that is not so easy. Therefore, we need the competence of well-educated people from all over the world, and it is not able and not an answer for us to separate us, to build new walls, to be intolerant, to say as a populist, Germany first, America first, or Britain first. No. For the humans, we have to build up the world. And if we have an influence, then we will do it in a better way than it is today. That is a hard work. Thank you very much for your attention.